Can you give the different branches of computer science?
So computer science is actually, it's integrated in everything in our lives, and we've never, like, I didn't know that before joining, and it was very exciting to get to know that. So for example, when you think of all the devices that you use at home, like microwaves and washing machines and stuff like that, those actually contain a huge portion of computer science, where the software developers are working on the very low level applications that do the running of all those devices. But also computer science can get very interesting if you look into machine learning and how artificial intelligence is getting like all over the place now in the world, and all those applications, like how Google image search, for example, would understand that the image you're looking at is the image of a flower, and what type of flower is it, and what color is the flower.
Okay.
Or like what other applications would know if they see your emotion and they would understand. All of this is type of machine learning. And we do that through pure computer science.
Okay.
There's also the study of theory, which is how you can make an application faster. How could you make things work in a more optimum way? How can you do approximations, and how can you make sure that the app is running correctly in a very solid way? And if you are a fan of movies and you've watched like all those movies around the Turing machine and all of that, were coming out last year.
I love that movie.
Yeah, it's amazing. This is the foundation of computer science theory.
Where do you really want to specialize in? What do you want to do?
So, other than working here at Google, I also worked for a company based in Boston. It's a spin-off from MIT, and it was purely machine learning.
Okay.
So, I really like working for this branch, and I would love to integrate it with graphics and animation. So, I think, I think it's one of the funnest things to do, to use graphics and animation in education and in making the process of learning stuff better. And I think that using computer science to make like the process of developing graphics and the process of coming up with creative content easy and it's facilitated for the creators, it's something that I would love to.
Do you think you're going to go into the field, or are you going to go back and do a master's?
I think I'm going to go into the field for a couple of years, just because I want to get to understand how the like in professional world how things run on a global scale or on a very large scale. Working here has definitely given me a huge insight on that, and it's actually very fun to understand how by doing a very small impact your impact propagates. I write Python and C++ and C,
Java,
and a bit of Java, but I'd like C++ more. And I'm an advocate of C++, which is very different. Like, it's a debatable thing in CES.
Like, which one's better? Which language is better? C++. Yeah. And so like you're advocating for C++?
Definitely.
So, I don't know if we're going to get a lot of dislikes for all this video for that. What is the best advice that you've ever gotten, or advice that you would give to your younger self?
The best advice that I've ever gotten was actually, we have here in Google something called ERGs, which is basically like extracurricular activities like in school.
Okay.
And one of them was called We++, which is Women in Engineering +++, like C++.
Ah. That's like the Google exclusive women's club.
Yeah. Okay. And they used to make us to prepare lunches with the women in senior positions. And we got to meet a lot of very interesting women, and one of them was talking about how you should always follow your passion and never be discouraged by the fact that maybe people won't agree with your opinion. And this was like the VP of Google Iris, which is like Google Glass, and she's like and like she talked about how people might not always be accepting your opinion or your idea, and if you're really passionate about it, you could definitely go places, even if you don't think you have the potential for it. So I would definitely be pushing myself for the coming years just to make sure I don't lose this passion or the fire that I have for the work. And also one other thing is that make sure that whatever you're doing has, even if it's like a very small impact on the society around you. Because sometimes we get so much dragged in what we're doing and in the industry, and we forget the fact that, we need to be giving back, or like our impact should propagate to other people.
Okay.
And this is something I always remind myself of, to have, like, to make sure that whatever I'm doing, even if it's in the advancement of the technology, it still has an impact on all sorts of skills in the society, and to have someone, like, benefit from what I'm doing. So,
is there anything else about women in STEM that we haven't touched on that you'd like to touch on? Or
women in STEM should work, like, should make sure that they're never disencouraged by the fact that it's a male dominated domain. Mm-hmm. I know that because, for example, my team here, it has a lot of males. I actually think that they are very empowering, they're very understanding, and they're very helpful. It's not a scary domain at all. I actually enjoy being part of this domain, and I feel like I'm very welcomed to join. So I would love for for more and more younger girls to be joining. I would say take a leap of faith and join computer science. It's one of the most creative domains you can work for. Mm-hmm. Now, and you're definitely going to grow both mentally and intellectually, and even from an impactful and societal side. So I would say that.